Hi guys, is it audible? Good evening, Lalan. Hey, it's corner cross me. No. No, it's not working. It's not working. Is it audible? Good evening. Is it audible? Can somebody confirm?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, we have to rotate the video. It's okay, but you are able to see, right? Yeah, I rotated the video. It's audible to, it's properly visible to me. Now, see here. For problems. As a kind of, what do you say? As a test, I have taken this slide. Thing here is, let us think of problems in theorems. See here, the moment it's problems in theorems, in all theorems, are at least 70% of networks mainly contain on only one thing. That is, we should be able to differentiate between whether we should use mesh analysis or nodal analysis in 70% of networks, including theorems also. So my main focus in this particular live is only one thing. That is, by seeing the problem, we should be able to differentiate whether we have to use mesh analysis or nodal analysis. Okay. Now let us start with, take down this question, hope it's visible, take down this question, this is I and this is 2I, this is voltage source, and for the circuit shown in figure, the Thevenin's voltage and resistance looking into XY, so this is X, this is Y. We have to find out Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance also. Try to find. And this is 1 ohm, 1 ohm, 2 amperes, 2 ohms. In Thevenin's, we discussed about three cases. First case, if you have only independent sources. If you have only independent sources, which method should be used? VOC should be calculated. And then directly RTH has to be found. Right? RTH. How to find RTH? The moment independent sources are there, all independent sources can be killed directly. And we have to look. For example, this is not a dependent source. If it is an independent source should be killed, independent source should be killed, and we have to look from this. But what is the second case? In second case, both independent variables will be there and also dependent variables will be there. Under that condition, what we are supposed to do, we have to calculate VOC also and ISC also. Okay? Now, let us try to find VOC. And here, I will tell you some mistakes normally people do. Okay, see here, VOC, open circuit condition and short circuit condition, this particular network is completely different. Configuration of the network is completely different and this particular configuration of network is completely different. Okay, so see here, whatever the values we are going to get in open circuit conditions, those particular values we are not supposed to use in short circuit conditions, because in open circuit these terminals are going to be open. In short circuit, these terminals are going to be closed, because multiple times what people do, some of the students, in open circuit condition, they will find some values. And those values, they will try to use in short circuit conditions also. We are not supposed to do that. Okay? Now, anyway, open circuit condition. See here, open circuit voltage has to be found. Okay? In order to find open circuit voltage, which method should be used? Basically, mesh should be used or model should be used. That's it. Now, for example, if I think of nodal, how many nodes are there? 1, 2, 3. Okay, so 3 nodes are available. Out of 3 nodes, one node will go as a reference node, one node will go as a reference node, and remaining 2 nodes, so 2 nodal equations will come. And many times, many students normally, somehow they will be habituated towards mesh analysis somehow. And they will try to use mesh analysis only. In BTEC level, it is fine. But in gate level or ESC level, whatever may be the methodology which is going to give you our response in a faster way, okay, that particular method only should be used. Now, anyway, in nodal analysis, reference node, one node, second node. And one more point here is, this particular thing is a voltage source. So the moment it's a voltage source, I need not apply KCL here, because directly voltage of this is going to be 2i only. We need not apply. So here only we are supposed to apply KCL. Okay? Because this particular voltage source is connected with respect to reference node. Okay? Meaning that only one KCL equation will be sufficient. Now, let us think of mesh. Okay? If I think of mesh analysis, see here, first mesh, second mesh, third mesh. Okay? So 3 mesh equations will come. Out of 3 mesh equations, one will be relation, because if I think of this as I1, if I think of this as I2, if I think of this as I3, and here I3 minus I2 equal to 2 amperes. Okay, so I3 minus I2 equal to 2 amperes, so this is going to be relation. Remaining 2 are going to be equations, right? See, this particular mesh equation will come. They are means combining altogether, one mesh equation will come and one relation will come. Which is better to use? Nodal analysis or mesh? With nodal analysis, only one equation. But with mesh analysis, 3 equations, one relation and 2 direct equations. So, compulsorily, we have to use nodal only, right? Try to use nodal in open circuit conditions. Open circuit voltage we are supposed to find. Now, see, this is V and this is reference. And for this, directly one voltage source is connected with respect to reference. So this particular voltage is directly 2i. Okay? Apply KCL here, problem solved. Now, let us try to apply KCL here. How much is, and one more thing I have to tell you. For example, just like that, forget about these things. Now, can I convert this particular 2i voltage source in series with resistance into equivalent current source or not? Okay, so this is particular voltage source, of course, dependent voltage source in series with resistance. Can I convert it into equivalent current source or not? Yes, we can convert. But logic here is, focus here, dear all of you. This is voltage source in series with resistance. For example, if I convert this, because some logic is there, few guys will do this mistake. For example, if I convert this into equivalent current source, what will happen? This is 2i divided by 1, so this is going to be 2i. And after that, let us think of resistance of 1 ohm. And after that, this resistance is there, no? So this resistance is there, 1 ohm, and remaining circuit will be there. Now, can I combine these two, 1 ohm resistance and 1 ohm resistance, and can I combinedly say it has 0.5 ohm or not? For example, if I convert this particular voltage source into current source, this particular voltage source into current source, then already 1 ohm resistance is there. Okay, so for this 1 ohm resistance here, now can I combine these two particular resistances or not? No, we are not supposed to combine it all, because here controlling variable is there, right? Okay, so the moment it is controlling variable, for example, if you combine these two, 1 ohm and 1 ohm, and if you write 0.5 ohm, then controlling variable is going to be disappeared or not? Yes. So the moment controlling variable is disappeared, how can you calculate 2i? Not possible. So always existence of life should be there for controlling variable. Otherwise, controlled source cannot be analyzed. Okay. Anyway, let us think of nodal analysis V, and this is V, this is reference, and current leaving, already you know, right? Current leaving only we take positive normally, okay? Because leaving. Now, V minus 2i, because this is 2i. V minus 2i divided by 1 plus V by 1 plus current leaving through this, V by 2, leaving current equal to entering current is going to be 2 ampere. Now, what about I value? Let us think of I value equal to how much? I value, this is V, this is 1 ohm, so V by 1, V. So V minus 2V, because this I is going to be V, so this is going to be 2V. So V minus 2V, minus V, plus V, okay. Now this is going to be V by 2 equal to 2. What is V is going to be 4 volts, right? Now how much is VOC, open circuit voltage, is going to be 4 volts, okay? In the options, two options remain. Now let us think of short circuit. And one thing I'm repeatedly telling you, this open circuit, whatever may be the voltages, currents, we are not supposed to use in short circuit conditions. In short circuit conditions, we are supposed to take all the values again from basic KCL, KVL only, okay? Now, let us think of, short circuit. In short circuit, normally in gate exam, they will give kind of tricky questions, but they will give definitely short questions. Let us think of short circuit here, okay? If a short circuit here, everything has to be calculated again. Now, see here, this is short circuited, and then this is 2 ohms resistance. Now, the moment 2 ohms resistance is there across short circuit, so through 2 ohms resistance, no current will flow. And across short circuit, 1 ohm is connected, so through 1 ohm, no current will flow. And if you think of current, this particular I, controlling variable, that controlling variable is going to be 0, meaning that control source is going to be having 0 volts. What is meant by 0 volts? It's a short circuit. 0 volts voltage is a short circuit, and 0 amperes current source is a open circuit. Now, if you see here, means once this is short circuited, this 1 ohm is also connected across this 1 ohm, across this 2 ohm, across this short circuit. So, total current has to flow through this short circuit only. Problem solved. So, VOC is going to be 4 volts, and ISC is going to be 2 amperes, so RTH would be 2 ohms. RTH would be 2 ohms. This is right. Okay. And one more thing is, intentionally I'm not seeing chart. I'm not responding. Why? I'll tell you tomorrow. Now, in the circuit shown, the voltage Vx in volts, if you're unable to see, this is 0.5 Vx, and this is plus minus 0.25 Vx, and here this is Vx. Try to solve. And dollar from EC will get questions. EC and instrumentation will get questions. Okay. First of all, you decide whether to use model analysis or mesh analysis. And most of the times, let me tell you, in GATE exam, most of the questions can be solved by kind of model analysis only, because they also know that in BTEC level, everybody feel comfortable with mesh analysis. And most of the questions, actually, if you see percentage of questions which can be solved by model easily, will be more compared to mesh. Meenakshi, I cannot rotate the camera because this is the new setup. You please rotate the camera. I too rotated my camera. You rotate, if you rotate the camera, it would be fine. Rotate the screen. Now, first of all, I asked you one thing. That is, mesh would be better or nodal would be better for this. See, how many nodes are there? First node, second node, third node. And this particular node is going to be reference node. Because the reference node, of course, definition previously I said in our full classes, like reference node should be, like any node can be considered as a reference node to which more connections are connected. Then, like number of equations or variables in one equation will be reduced. Anyway, more connections are connected to here, this particular node, take this as a reference node. And this first node, this is second node. So, two nodal equations are required. Two nodal equations are required. Out of which, already one voltage source is connected with respect to reference node. So, this is going to be 0.25x directly, because it's a voltage source. Voltage dependent voltage source. So the moment it is a voltage source, I need not apply KCL here. So only one time I have to apply KCL here. So nodal KCL equation, only one time you have to apply. Now let us think of mesh analysis. If you think of mesh analysis, let me use some other color. If I think of mesh analysis, how many mesh equations will come? See here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so total 4 equations are required, but see here, if I think of this as I1, because I told you clearly, like if any ideal current source is connected across, like outermost loop, in that particular concerned mesh, we need not apply KVL. Directly, I1 is nothing but 5 amperes only, you know. So, I1 equal to 5 amperes. One equation is done. And second equation, I1, let me think of this as I2, let me think of this as I3, let me think of this as I4. How much is I4? 0.5 Vx. I4 is going to be 0.5 Vx. Okay? So, see here, this current source is connected to the outermost loop. So, to that concerned mesh, we need not apply KVL. And this particular current source is connected to the outermost loop. So, in the concerned mesh, we need not apply KVL. Directly, currents can be known. Now, this is a direct relation. This is direct relation, but two times you have to apply KVL. So two times you have to apply KVL. And only one time you have to apply KCL. So which should be better? Nodal will be better. So let us apply nodal. Nodal would be better. Because in each and every question or problem, if we can analyze that way, then like very easily we can solve the questions in GATE. Okay. Now nodal. See, this is going to be directly 0.25 Vx. 0.25 Vx. And Vx is here. Vx is here. And here we have to apply one more node. This is Vx. Vx. Write equation. Only here only we are supposed to write equation, right? Because this is where we can write KCL, not here. It directly one voltage source is connected. Okay, now see here, Vx by 20 plus Vx, this voltage is minus 0.25 Vx divided by 10. Okay, so this current is over, this current is over, then this current, leaving current, leaving current, leaving current, leaving current, same node, no, same node. So how much is that leaving current plus 0.5x? Leaving current, leaving current, leaving current, leaving current, and this particular current is entering into the node. So A equal to 5 amperes. Okay, now try to do that, you will get the answer. How much it would be? Equals. Did you get 8 volts? Did you get 8 volts? Yes, Abhijit. Now, focus. Focus on the whether to choose mesh analysis or nodal analysis. That is heart of this discussion. Because theorems. You know theorems, I know theorems. Now, let us take this. Maximum power transfer theorem mixed with Thevenin's. In the circuit shown, what value of RL maximizes the power delivered to RL? Maximizes the power delivered to RL. This is 4 ohm, 4 ohm, Vx, 4 ohm, and Vx is here, this is 100 volt. Okay? How to do that? We have dependent source and we have independent source also. We have dependent source and we have independent source also. Right? First of all, see the question first. Because all the time, the moment you have independent and dependent, doesn't mean that we have to calculate both VOC and ISC. Because they did not ask Thevenin's equivalent or Norton's equivalent voltage or current. Thevenin's equivalent voltage they did not ask. They are and Norton's equivalent current they did not ask. They are asking only RTH, resistance. Right? So therefore means we have to focus on, because with VOC ISC the problem is VOC configuration of the system is different. ISC configuration of the system is different. So in calculating open circuit voltage, you have to calculate everything from KCL, KVL mesh nodal. In calculating short circuit current also, you have to calculate everything from KCL, KVL or mesh nodal, right? So two configurations of the systems, why to analyze? Because they ask only resistance. Now see here, we have three types of configurations, right? So first is independent sources, With independent sources, if you want to calculate RTH only, what you are going to do, you are going to kill all the sources, and from those two terminals, from where you want to calculate Thevenin's equivalent resistance, from those two terminals, you are going to look into the system and you are going to calculate by killing all sources, by deactivating all independent sources, because independent sources can be killed, not dependent sources. Now, second thing is, if you have both independent and dependent, okay, what we can do is VOC, one configuration of the circuit, ISC, another configuration of the circuit, and then RTH equal to VOC by ISC. Right? Now let us think of third one. Third one, when you have only dependent sources. When you have only dependent sources, what you are supposed to do? Because VOC will become 0 volts, ISC will become 0 amperes. Then, how to activate dependent source? In order to activate dependent source, if I have a system like this, which are having only dependent sources, under that conditions, we are going to excite it by some voltage source or current source. Independent sources, external excitation. Now, for example, if I excite this with voltage source, I repeat, if I excite this voltage source, then source current I'm going to find such that RTH equal to source voltage by source current. or you can replace this with current source also. But depending upon the circuit, I will tell you whether to use voltage source or current source. Okay. Now, see here. Anyway, in this case, all independent sources can be killed. But if you think of in this case, if I want to calculate only RTH, why don't we apply this particular thing here? Happily we can apply. Because independent sources can be killed. Now, for example, if I have a circuit, if I want to find only RTH under that condition, independent sources if I can kill. Because if I don't use this, VOC one configuration of the system, ISC another configuration of the system. So two circuits we are supposed to calculate, is it required for us? Okay. Of course, VOC can be calculated, ISC can be calculated, as per that RTH also can be calculated. But two circuits, why to analyze? Because they asked only RTH. If they would have asked VOC and RTH, then there is no other way. These things have to be calculated, right? Now, the moment if I kill all independent sources, circuit will become only with dependent. Then externally excite the circuit with some external source. Then directly RTH can be found. RTH can be found. And only one circuit we are supposed to analyze. Okay. Now let us think of let us externally excite the system by killing all independent sources. What is the main independent source here? Independent sources can be killed, but can I kill dependent source? No. Okay. Now externally we have to excite the system. So externally let us excite the system with voltage source or current source, which should be better, because means in the exam each and every second also should be optimized. It is not like, okay, I have some lengthy process, I will follow that only. No, it's not like that. We should be able to individually optimize the time. Let me draw it again. Once it is short circuited, this is going to be RL external, and this is 4 ohm, this is 4 ohm, this is 4 ohm, this is plus minus Vx, right? Now which would be better, voltage source or current source? Vx is somewhere here. External excitation, which should be better, voltage source or current source? Voltage source or current source? It should be voltage source. Let me think of 8 volts. Because anyway, our systems are linear, right? I can take 1 volts also, I can take 80 volts also. Means it doesn't matter much. Because V by I only will come. Now, the moment if I use voltage source, what is the advantage? Directly I can say that 8, 4, 4. So 8 divided by 8 is going to be 1 ampere current. Such that voltage across this will become 4 into 1 is going to be 4 volts. Now the moment Vx is becoming constant, because of this it became constant, because of this it will become constant. So this is going to be 4 volts. Don't my point, right? If I take current source, I cannot, what they say, make it constant. Though it is dependent source, if I make depending variable, a controlling variable constant, automatically controlled source also will become almost like independent source, right? Now done. Now 8 volts is there, I am supposed to find out the current here, that is source current. 8 by 8, 1 ampere is leading through this. Because directly I cannot find current flowing through a voltage source. Means for a voltage source, voltage is constant, but what about the current value? That particular current value will be decided by the system connected, external system. For a current source, current is known. But what about the voltage across current source? That should be decided by the system connected. Okay, now coming to here, see. Means how much current would flow through this? This is 4 volts. This is 8 volts. So 8 minus 4 by 4 is going to be 1 ampere. 1 plus 1 is going to be 2 ampere. 8 by 2 is going to be 4 ohm. Now, if I can have this RL of 4 ohms, maximum power would be transformed. I'm going to consider some AC questions also. Is it done? Now it's kind of very old question, gate 89, but it is important because superposition cannot be applied to power calculation. Superposition can be applied only to current voltage calculations, but not for power calculation. Just to remind that I have taken this question, that's it. Yeah, Abhijit Namo, that's true. That's true. You can replace before one. Yeah, Parthamesh, that's true. If RTH can be negative, that will become active, right? Is voice audible? Somebody is saying voice is too low. Is voice audible? Ms. Alok is saying voice is not audible. Yeah, Pradhamesh Kulkarni. Go through the question again, yeah, it cannot be 3 watt. It cannot be 3 watt, buddy. I don't have headphones. Is it not audible at all? Is it not audible at all? By headphone, it seems it is audible. Yes, that's fine. Now, see this particular question. Logic here is, see here, means they have given very simple. Plus, minus, this is V1. And this is plus, minus, this is V2. Means the question, I'll tell you. When V1 is, active, and V2 is dead, in this is deactivated, then power absorbed in this 1 ohm resistance is 1 watt. And when this is active alone, and when this is short circuit, because voltage source, like in order to kill voltage source, it should be short circuited. So when this is acting alone, and this is killed, then power is 4 watt. When both the sources are acting simultaneously, then how much is the power absorbed in resistance? See here, point here is, with resistance or with power, we cannot apply superposition. Okay? Of course, in AC, okay, forget about it. Now, see here, let us think of resistance. And plus is here, minus is here. Plus is here, minus is here. When this is not active, when this is dead, current would go somewhere in this direction. This resistance is 1 ohm. Right? Then, how much is the power absorbed? Power absorbed when only first the active element is activated. First source is activated. Then they said that it has 1 watt. Now, directly, means that power, in power calculations, we cannot apply superposition. But with current and voltage, we can apply. So, this is going to be I1 square R equal to 1. Resistance is already 1 ohm. This is 1 ohm. Okay. So, I1 is going to be 1 ampere. Fine. Let us think of second case. When second source is active alone, and after that, this is killed. At that moment of time, current will go in this direction. This is I2. And how much is P2 they have given? P2 they have given as 4 watt. That is going to be I2 square R equal to 4. Resistance is 1 ohm. So I2 is going to be 2 ampere. So this is 2 ampere in this direction, and this is 1 ampere. This is 1 ampere in upward direction. So how much is the resultant when both the sources are acting? Both the sources are acting. Current is going to be 1 ampere in downward direction, flowing through 1 ohm resistance. So net power is going to be 1 watt. Net power is going to be 1 watt. Okay. This is a beautiful question. This is a wonderful question. Actually, we bought new camera, kind of testing. We had to find out whether it is portrait mode or some kind of stuff. This is a very good question. Take it. Beautiful question, beautiful question. Yeah, Surajit, 0.8 is right. Assuming both the voltage sources are in phase, this 10 volts and 3 volts are in phase. And the value of R for which maximum power is transformed from circuit A to circuit B. Means my circuit A is supposed to transform maximum power to circuit B. Okay, forget about all. Ultimately, if you consider only circuit A, because reference is circuit A, they have given. So this is going to be 10 volts and this is 2 ohms. In order to have maximum power transformed, how much should be the load resistance equivalent? Is going to be 2 ohm, no? 2 ohm, right? Now how much would be the current flowing? 10 by 4. 2.5 amperes. How much should be the voltage here? Voltage going to 2 ohm, 2 ohm. So ultimately it should be 5 volt. Problem solved. Means that here voltage should be 5 volts. And here 2 ohms current should be 2.5 amperes. Now current you know. Voltage across this resistance you know. How much is that here with respect to reference? This is 3 volts and with respect to this is 5 volts. So 5 minus 3 is going to be 2 volts. Calculate resistance value means V by I. Okay. So how much is the resistance value? 2 volts. Voltage across resistance divided by current flowing through the same resistance is 2.5 is going to be 0.8 ohm. Right? Yeah, this question is from maximum power transfer theorem. Aryan Verma, true. So this is workbook practice question, is it? I didn't know actually. Because in our team, already you know, right, Surajit? I did not prepare, or our faculty team did not prepare workbooks intentionally. Because if I fill workbook, if I write workbook, obviously my favorite questions only will be there. But new questions should come, right? So content team is different, faculty team is different. Workbook questions are different, our faculty questions are different. It can be from workbook, I don't know. And this is funny question, simple question. Maybe for... new guys, it may look a bit good, but for old guys, it is easy question. Between A and B, they connected R, such that R should get maximum power from the network. And one thing I have to tell you here, that's why I have taken this. If I, actually I don't have plus minus, right? Normally, if I have, how to represent voltage source, compulsorily plus minus polarity should be there. Without polarities, voltage definition is void. Always for a voltage, plus minus should be there, independent of DC or AC already, you know. So this is not sufficient as a voltage source. Compulsorily, they are supposed to mention that. And for current source, direction is compulsory for a current. But if they want to mention it is AC, they can mention like this. But now, they didn't do anything. Like whether plus minus also they didn't mention, and the direction of current also they didn't mention. Now, will it be voltage source or current source? It should be voltage source only. Because most of the times we deal with voltage source only. So let us assume it as a voltage source, even though they don't mention. Okay? Now see, this is the first case. We are having only independent sources only, kill the independent source. And from these two, we have to look into the system. Already you know one thing. What is that? Whenever you find long short circuit pass, give node numbers. If I think of this as A, already they have given B, let me think of this as X. And long, once it is short circuited, long short circuit path, it also will become X. Okay? A to X 3K, A to X 6K, they are in parallel. B to X 4K, B to X 4K connected in parallel. So ultimately, this circuit will become, right? So this is A, and 3K, 6K are in parallel, and this is going to be X. From X, again we got two parallel paths. Again we got two parallel paths. That is going to be 4K, 4K. See here, X to B, B to X. So this is going to be B. X to B, 4K. X to B, 4K. And between A to B, we are supposed to calculate the equivalent resistance symbol. So this is going to be 6 into 3 by 6 plus 3, 9, R1, R2 by R1 plus R2. And 4K, 4K is going to be 2K. This is going to be 2 plus 2. Will be the answer. And yeah, actually this has given in EC paper for them kind of. Okay, because the moment they see like inductance, capacitance, AC analysis, phasor concepts and all, they'll be a bit scared there. But electrical guys, it's easy peasy. See, here also they did not mention plus minus. One thing, why I have taken this question, I'll tell you. See here, between A and B, Thevenin's equivalent voltage source, they ask. Thevenin's equivalent voltage VTH. So what is your ultimate target? Ultimate target is you are supposed to find voltage. When you are supposed to find voltage in voltage calculations, anything parallel with respect to like kind of ideal voltage source can be neglected because, see here, what is the difference between here to here potential difference? 100 at an angle 0, 100 at an angle 0, 100 at an angle 0. So whenever you want to calculate voltages or while applying KVL, because voltage, KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, and then mesh analysis. In these three, if anything is connected across ideal voltage source can be neglected, but if you are calculating currents, if you are calculating power, these are also should be there. Okay, for example, if you want to calculate voltage across this 100 at angle 30, then in that case, if I remove these two. In voltage calculation, we can remove these two. But for example, if you want to calculate current flowing through this, can you remove these two? No. Means this also will consume current. This also will consume current. This also will have some power. This also will have some power. So while calculating power calculations, while doing power calculations, while doing current calculations, if anything is connected in parallel with ideal voltage source, has to be considered. Okay. Now, anyway. If you think of current source, if anything is connected in series with, one more question I have taken here. If anything is connected in series with ideal current source can be neglected in calculating currents, not voltages, not towers, in calculating currents. Currents in the sense in applying KCL. KCL in the sense in applying nodal analysis. Now anyway, we want to calculate voltage only, so we can neglect how much is VTH, open circuit voltage is going to be. So if you remove these two, current is going to be 100 at an angle 0 divided by 3 plus J4 is going to be the current flowing through J4 into J4 will be the voltage. That's it. Will be the voltage. If you want, this is going to be 100 J4 divided by 3 plus J4 into 3 minus J4 into 3 minus J4. Right? So this is going to be 100, okay, let us think of 400 J 3 minus J4 divided by 25. Right? So this is going to be 16. J16, 3 minus J4. Right? Actually, by seeing it, you may feel that it is kind of very difficult question, but in reality it is not. Is it visible? Is it visible? Yeah, it's visible. And let me write here, this is going to be plus minus VL, and this is 10 VL, and this is current is I2, and this current is voltage source is going to be J40 I2. Okay. And this is 3 plus J4, this is J6, 5, 10. And source voltage is 100 at an angle 53.13. Try to solve. And 10 VL is a voltage source and VL is a voltage here. Meaning that, what does it mean? It's a depending variable is voltage and dependent source is voltage. Meaning that it's going to be voltage controlled voltage source. If you think of here, plus minus is there, meaning that voltage source, but it is depending upon I2. So it is going to be current dependent voltage source. Current dependent voltage source, okay? Now, simple. See here, logic here is very simple. Then Thevenin's equivalent voltage in volts as seen by the load resistance RL. Thevenin's equivalent voltage. So you have to remove RL, right? The moment you remove RL, how much will be I2? I2 would be 0. If I2 is 0, 40 I2 is going to be 0. Meaning that it's a voltage source, so it is going to behave like a short circuit. Okay, so the moment current is 0, across this how much voltage is going to be? 10 ohms you are going to remove and no current is flowing through this. So voltage across this is going to be 10 VL, right? So this is going to be 10 VL. Now, VTH is going to be no drop here because no current is flowing. So 10 VL is going to be 10 into, what is VL? What is VL? Current multiplied by J4. Okay, so how much is that? My voltage is going to be 100 at an angle 53.13 divided by 3 plus J4, because this is already short, right? 3 plus J4 into J4. Into J4. This is current multiplied by impedance, voltage, 10 into voltage is going to be that. That's it. So this is very simple. J40 into 100 at an angle 53.13 divided by 5 at an angle 3 plus J4, right? Same angle, 53.13. So net is going to become J 800 or 800 at an angle 90. Fine. Answer is, yeah, answer is C. This is reciprocity theorem. Use data given in figure A. The current I in the circuit of figure B, we have to calculate. So this is figure A. This is figure A. By using this data, we are supposed to find current here. It is simple question. Reciprocity there. See here, 20 volts, 10 volts. So if I multiply this way by 2, 20 volts, it is going to be in this direction, 2 into 2 is going to be 4 amperes. Now, if I place that particular 20 volts this side, if I place 20 volts this side, current flowing through this would be 4 amperes. Okay? If plus is on the top, plus is on the top, current is going to be in this direction of 4 amperes. If plus is in the down, current will be in this direction. Of 4 amperes, right? Now they are asking current in downward direction is going to be minus 4 amperes, right? Minus 4. Not an equivalent current. Meaning that short circuit current they are asking. Across peak. Simple. See here, once I short circuit this, through this no current will flow. And here means this short circuit and this are connected in series, and this are connected in parallel. Current division rule, total current entering is 16 amperes. Right? So this is going to be 16 into other resistance, because I want to calculate short circuit current. Total current into other resistance 25 divided by total resistance or total impedance 25 plus 15 plus J30 will be the Norton's current or short circuit current. Six point four minus J four point eight. Okay. This was a bit good question. See, they asked Thevenin's voltage also and Thevenin's equivalent resistance also. Okay, both resistance they asked and voltage also they asked. And we are going to have dependent source and independent source also. Meaning that VOC we have to calculate, ISC also we have to calculate. Right? Do it. Our main focus is which one to use, right? Whether to choose mesh analysis or nodal analysis matter. Now, if you think of here, okay, means this is going to be VOC, right? This is going to be VOC with respect to the open circuit voltage. Okay, and how many nodes are there basically if you go with nodal analysis? First node, second node, third node, fourth node. Four nodes are there. Out of four nodes, one node go as a reference node. And after that, this node we need not bother because this is connected with respect to reference node. What is the voltage source value of this is going to be 0.5 I1, right? So the moment any voltage source is connected with respect to reference node, we need not apply KCL there. Directly that voltage value is 0.5 I1. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, out of 4 reference node, ideal voltage source. Okay, so remaining two equations. In these two also, again, this is going to be with respect to reference node only. So this is directly 10 volts. Only one nodal equation. If you think of mesh, because we have to check the mesh, and then we have to decide whether to go with mesh or nodal. If you go with mesh, I1, I2, there are two meshes. Out of that, see here, one current source is connected here. So how much is I1 here? For example, if I think of this as IX, and if I think of this as IY, IX and IY, how much is IX? IX is going to be 1 ampere, no? IX is going to be 1 ampere. IX is going to be 1 ampere. Directly we know. So we have to apply KVL here only. Get my point, right? So if you use nodal analysis, only one equation. If you use mesh analysis, one equation. Okay? If you use nodal analysis, directly 10 volts, directly 0.51, here only you have to apply. If you want to use mesh analysis, only in this particular mesh only, we are supposed to write down the equation. Now you tell me, which is better, mesh or nodal? Because we have to optimize each and everything. Right? Means each and every second also should be optimized. Because it is network, just like that we should run the show. Which is better? Mesh or nodal? First of all, process has to be enjoyed. Some people might know the answers, right? But the process, did you analyze? Like which mesh analysis would be better or nodal analysis would be better. Okay, if you analyze, automatically that analysis will work because the same question will never come in gate exam again, right? Yeah, that is also fine, Pradamesh Kulkarni, because Pradamesh, this is network theory, anyway we can do, right? For example, because boundaries should be known. If you know boundaries, we can play inside. For example, this 10 volts is there, 5 ohm is there. One voltage source connected in series with resistance, can I convert that into equivalent current source or not? You please tell me first. Can I convert this 10 volts is there, 5 ohm is there? Can I convert these two into equivalent current source or not? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Kulkarni. Good, yes. Okay, let us see. Yes or no? Yeah, no. Because dependent variable is there. See here. Here, for example, let me take 10 volt, maybe 2 ohm, just like that. And outside network is there. That outside network is open circuited, for example. It is open circuited. Now, how much would be the voltage here? Because the moment outside network is open circuited, means how much would be the current flowing through? That is going to be 0 ampere, so this is going to be 0 volts. Now, if I convert this into equivalent current source, 10 by 2, 5 amperes. And again here also network is open circuited. External network is open circuited and 10 by 2, 5 ohm. Now if external circuit is open circuited, this is also open circuited. How much is the voltage inside? 0 volts. But how much is the voltage here? This is 10 by 2, 5. This is 2 volts. This is 2 volts. Okay. So, see here, means once outside network is open circuited, 5 into 2, 10 volts will be there. Now, can I say these two are equivalent circuits inside? No, these two are equivalent circuit to external world. External world. But inside, they are not equal. Getting my point, right? Because in the open circuit case of external world, this is 0 volts. In the open circuit case of external world, this is 10 volts, voltage across resistance. No. See here. Because controlling variable is here. Controlling variable is here. Depending upon this controlling variable, this 0.51 is there. 0.51 is there. So we are not supposed to transform at all. Anyway, see here, mesh is better or nodal is better? What is the output? What is the output requirement? Output requirement is open circuit voltage. For example, okay, this is over. Leave about it. Come to here. If you think of nodal analysis, one nodal equation. If you think of mesh analysis, one mesh equation, but which is better? But what is the required output? Required output is voltage, no? And in between mesh and nodal, in which case you are going to get output voltage is going to be nodal. With nodal, directly output will come. But with mesh, you have to find out the current. And after that, you have to apply KVL again in order to find out the voltage. So, let us go with nodal analysis. Because in nodal analysis, direct voltage you are going to get. Right? In mesh analysis, current we have to get. So, if the output requirement is current, for example, in this particular case, when number of mesh equations required and number of nodal equations required are same, under that condition, which has to be chosen? If they ask you current, go with mesh. If they ask you voltage, go with nodal. Okay? Now, let me think of nodal. This is V, which is another open circuit, and this is going to be V. Now, let us apply nodal V minus 10. V minus 10 by 5 plus V by 5. Leaving current is equal to minus 1 or equal to 1. So how much is going to be V by 5 plus V by 5 equal to 2 plus 1, 3. So 2V by 5 equal to 3 or 15 by 2 is going to be 7.5 volt. Only one option is given. If you want, you can calculate short circuit current also. For example, if I want to calculate short circuit current, across short circuit, 5 ohms resistance is there, so no current will flow through this. And this 10 volts, and this 10 volts will drive 10 by 5, 2 amperes current. And through this, no current will go, so 1 ampere current. So net is going to be 3 ampere current. So short circuit current is going to be 3 ampere. Open circuit voltage is 7.5 volt. So net is going to be 7.5 by 3. Resistance is going to be 2.5. Okay. Now, I have taken class for 1 hour 10 minutes. Of course, we have 5 more problems. These are the problems. Okay. See here, I am stopping the class here. Because in Hyderabad, some lockdown is going on. We may have to go to home very soon. Just for comparison, because tomorrow I will make a video. 1 hour roughly 5 minutes or 7 minutes I have taken to solve 12 questions. Tomorrow I'll release one more video. Just let us see. Okay. Yeah, Parthamesh, you are going with what do you say? From options, you are trying to derive the approach. That is fine, but if they give you in numerical of questions, because most of the questions are going to be numerical in gate, right? Then it would be a problem. Sumit, don't think that India is completely Hindi. Okay. Yes, Prathamesh, that's it. Thank you guys, thank you so much.